Welcome back. Thank you for your huge response online to our special series, The Changing Face of Sydney. Tonight, we examine how after years of spreading out, Sydney is finally growing up, literally. Urban sprawl is no solution to our housing shortage and inflated housing market. As our population hits 5 million next year, many more of us will start to live in mini-cities that are far bigger than most country towns. 50 years ago, Sydney looked very different. Our icons were infants still under construction. Our health and safety not quite as rigorous.
Up, up, up. More office space for more office workers.
But our skyline was changing. It felt dramatic then, but nothing compared to what's coming.
The face of Sydney is constantly changing.
Behind me is Barangaroo, once known as the Hungry Mile, once a bustling port. By the late 1990s, it was out of date, neglected, all but abandoned. But not any longer. If anything typifies the changing face of Sydney, it's the $2 billion reinvigoration of this once forgotten harbourfront. 8 prime hectares of hotels, offices, shops and apartments. 100,000 visitors a week, home to tens of thousands of workers and residents. The future.
What Barangaroo represents is a scale of project that allows a full range of mixes to exist in the same place. It's also carbon neutral and it creates fantastic new public spaces as well.
Old Sydney was about living in the burbs, commuting to work, travelling for our entertainment and driving to the weekly shop. New Sydney is about having work, sleep and play all within a 20-minute radius.
People want to be able to walk out their front door and to live their lives fully rather than having to get on a train or a bus or in a car and to travel an hour or so.
As Sydney takes to the sky, so did I. Because it's not only the CBD that's on the rise, the Sydney of the future will be many cities, multiple high-rise, high-density hubs, north, south, east, and especially west. Right below me is Parramatta, the geographic heart of the city. What's about to happen down there is a multi-billion dollar transformation. Imagine Shanghai on the Parramatta River. A multi-billion dollar rebuild, including Sydney's tallest residential tower, 53 stories high. There are even plans for a beach.
The vision for Sydney has to include Parramatta really genuinely becoming our second CBD.
Former Lord Mayor Lucy Turnbull says it's the way of the future.
And similarly, the Penriths, the Liverpools, the Campbelltowns, the Blacktowns, the Chatswoods, they have to really fulfil their destiny to become great cities within our metropolitan city.
The quarter-acre block has had its day. Urban sprawl is no solution to our housing shortage and overheated housing market. Sydney's population is simply growing too fast.
It is going to mean different lifestyles, more densification, living in vertical communities.
And just down there is another prime example. Let's land, I'll show you why. This is Thornton in North Penrith. For much of its life, the land around here was home to the army, some light industry, a few farming paddocks and not much else. Not for very much longer. Very soon, Sydney's outer west will rival the inner city in the way it looks and feels. Out with the old, in with the $200 million new. Over 41 hectares, 1,100 new homes, as well as retail, offices and parkland. The way we live is changing.
We are seeing a definite shift to more urban living, and that's, you know, apartment living.
We've left one of the most dramatic transformations to last. I'm over Oran Park, 70 kilometres from the centre of Sydney. It was once a racetrack. More recently, a dairy farm. But the cows are going. The stampede is on. In just 15 years, this will be a mega hub for 135,000 people. From paddock to full-blown city in no time flat.
You're going to see a whole brand new town pop out of the ground.
Year by year, it's expanding, and this man couldn't be happier.
heaps of schools, shops, leisure centres, libraries, the whole thing will be there. So hopefully you won't have to leave Oran Park to go somewhere else. You can just do everything you need there. You can work there, you can live there, you can shop there.
That 20-minute rule again, the future of Sydney. But will our transport be able to cope? That's tomorrow.